Hunting down gravitational waves is one of the most challenging engineering endeavors of the 21st century, and now physicists are planning on launching that hunt into space. Hello, I'm Ian O'Neill, space producer for Discovery News, and I'm here to quickly talk about another nugget of gravitational wave coolness. If you're familiar with my videos on DNews, you'll know that I love gravitational waves, or more precisely, I love the prospect of gravitational wave astronomy. Gravitational waves are basically ripples in space-time. Imagine the ripples across the surfaces of a pond after dropping a pebble in the water. These ripples carry energy away from the plop in the surface. If we wanted to, we could analyze the amplitude, speed, and direction of these ripples to determine the mass of the pebble that fell in and gain some useful information about the water they're propagating through. This model is quite useful for us to imagine how gravitational waves work. If we could detect and measure them, we could reveal some incredible science about the objects creating space-time ripples. Gravitational waves were first theorized by Einstein nearly 100 years ago. We have strong indirect evidence that they're out there, but directly detecting them has been very difficult. However, we're slowly closing in. As I've explained in a previous video, the US-based Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, or LIGO detector, has recently been upgraded to begin the most precise search for gravitational waves ever. There are high hopes that through new noise reduction laser techniques, that gravitational waves will not only be identified, but they will also be used to see energetic events such as black hole and neutron star collisions, supernovas, and potentially the effects of dark matter. Basically, once this is achieved, the era of gravitational wave astronomy has begun. But there's an even more advanced detector plan that could revolutionize our view of the cosmos, and it involves sending a gravitational wave detector into space, far from all the noise and commotion we have down here on Earth. Europe's Evolved Laser Interferometer Space Antenna, or ELISA, is tentatively scheduled to be launched into Sun orbit in 2034, and this will consist of three spacecraft. The three probes will form three points in a triangle spaced millions of miles apart, setting up the mother of all laser interferometers in space. Laser interferometry is perfect for measuring extremely tiny fluctuations in distance, and this is necessary for detecting faint gravitational wave signals. As ELISA will be in space, this detector will be even more sensitive to gravitational waves than LIGO, revealing energetic events in far-off galaxies. But 2034 is a long time to wait. Why is it going to take this long to launch the next big thing in the gravitational wave hunt? In short, the technology isn't there yet, and the final design of ELISA isn't close to being finalized. But later this year, the first component of ELISA will be launched to test some key technologies. The European Space Agency is going to send a single probe called the LISA Pathfinder to the Sun-Earth Lagrangian point, L1. The L1 point is an island of gravitational stability located between the Sun and the Earth, where gravity between them balances out. It's approximately 1.5 million kilometers away, where we have several probes and space telescopes currently anchored. The Pathfinder probe will have a scaled-down interferometer on board, set up between two masses inside. It's basically going to be a grand physics laboratory experiment to test how an interferometer will function in the space environment. Although it's not designed to seek out gravitational waves, this will be the seed of ELISA. So 2034 may be a long way off, but if all goes to plan, LIGO would have already detected gravitational waves by then, and ELISA will be our new eye in the sky to weed out the weakest gravitational wave signals from the deepest depths of our universe. And LISA Pathfinder will be the first stepping stone to this ultimate goal. For more information about Advanced LIGO, which has just gone online, check out my recent video. As gravitational waves wash through the Earth, yes, I said through as in through us, there's a tiniest of tiny shrinkage or expansion in local space-time. Make sure you check out that video. There's a link in the description if you're on your mobile device. And let us know in the comments below about your thoughts on the quest to find gravitational waves.